Hello students, good evening. Welcome to the another live session by Shikwa at Subskill. Hope all the students are joining there. Okay, so you all might aware that the Capgemini is on the way to conduct their recruitment drive as well in the upcoming few couple of days. And you all students also started, might have started your preparation for the Capgemini drive as well. In this video, I'm going to share you about the Capgemini recruitment pattern, which is in more of a couple of videos, in the couple of past videos as well, I have mentioned about that as well. But this is something very exciting and something very wonderful that I'm bringing in front of you through this live session and through this video. Okay, I'm going to explain you about how our game-based aptitude platform, which we have dedicatedly built to help you prepare for the game-based assessment for the Capgemini, that is going to help you to crack this down. So let's go ahead first to start with the Capgemini pattern of the recruitment test pattern. First, let us understand what and all the sections that are going to be there in the Capgemini recruitment test. So very first is the English communication test, technical assessment pseudocode. So questions of pseudocode are going to be asked to you there. The second one is multiple choice question on English communication test. We are also going to cover the basics of that English communication session tomorrow's session as well, and in which you'll be also able to learn about what and all the important things, what and all the important concepts from the game-based assessment, right? And what and all the important concepts from the English communication test. And in my today's session, I'm going to explain you about our own platform that is going to help you to practice the game-based assessment, because in many of the tests and in many of the platforms, you might have came across the things to prepare the game-based assessment, where they'll be giving you the pattern and they'll be giving you the four options to select to choose one of those games, those answers for the games, particular games. But that is not giving the actual feel of how you should be able to practice all those games and how you should be able to play the exact actual games, because in the Capgemini gamified assessment test, you will be having around 4 to 5 games where you have to play those games. And that is the really challenging thing for most of the students, because they don't even know how to take those decisions, how to understand and how to answer for all of those gamified assessment questions, right? Then the next is behavioral competency profiling, which is actually not going to be considered for the shortlisting purpose, but it is also going to play a very important role as far as the Capgemini test is concerned. Then the final is technical and HR interview. Okay, so it is also very important from the perspective of Capgemini recruitment, right? So all in all, there is a three sections that are having the sectional cutoff. The first is technical assessment pseudocode. The second is multiple choice questions on the English communication test, and the third is game-based aptitude, gamified assessment. Okay, so in my today's session, I'm going to focus more on game-based assessment. We have a dedicated platform, we have a dedicated portal where students can come and they can play the games. And this is available for the students, those who will be enrolling for our courses, various courses, mostly for MGrad to Silver, which is all-in-one preparation package, where you can prepare for all the upcoming drives, all the companies for which and on which I have yesterday only, I have shared all the important things and important deliverables, offerings, commercials, all the things in my yesterday's video. So you can go to that live and you can check what are the things that we are offering in the course of MGrad Pro Silver. That is also going to help you. One more thing I would like to remind you all guys is, again, subscribe to our YouTube channel. That is really going to help you to get more updates, more and more updates that we are bringing to help you out to crack all the upcoming drives and all the upcoming campus placements. That is really going to make a huge differences in your life as well. Okay, so let's go to look at the game-based assessment portal and how that is going to help you. So students, just those who are live, just type one in the comment box if you are able to watch the portal in front of you, which is for the game-based assessment. And now I'm going to share you about how we are going to help and how we are going to start your preparation for this game based assessment. Okay, so just type one in the chat box if you are able to watch the window for the game based assessment over here. So this is window for gamified assessment. Now all those students who will be enrolling for our courses, that may be for Capgemini course, Capgemini Exceller course, and even that may be for the MGrad Pro Silver, because in the MGrad Pro Silver we are also covering the important things in the Capgemini Exceller course as well, right? So all those students who will be enrolling for our platform, they will be getting the access of this game based assessment. So first what you need to do is we will be giving you the URL onto our application, where you have to go there and you have to first enter your email ID. Okay, I will just enter my email ID over here. Okay, now once you click on send OTP, that will send an OTP to your email address that you have entered. Now you have to verify, our system will verify whether that email ID has the access of starting this particular practice or not, and according to that it will verify the user and then he will be able to start his preparation. Okay, I'll enter my OTP over here. On verify. Okay, so this is the portal, or this is the dashboard which is there in front of you now, where you will be really going to play the games, actual games which are going to be asked there in the Capgemini test, and you will be really getting that feel of how you have to take the decisions, how you have to solve all those game based assessments in the Capgemini test. So these are the four games that we are providing you. Mostly we have studied all the earlier recruitment patterns, recruitment tests that they have conducted since now, and according to that we have developed these games into our platform. So how you can play it, there is option of starting this particular game. So suppose identify the correct order, this is the first game, so I will click on the start. So once I click on the start, the game is there in front of me now. So here in this, what you have to do is you have to identify the order of rearrangement. Okay, so what I have to do is this is the first order which I have been given. The plus sign is the one, so square is second, triangle is third, and circle is four, and this has been rearranged in the different sequence. So I have to identify in which sequence it has been there. So the second one is the first, then third one is the second. So in that way this sequence will go around like 2, 3, 4, and 1. I'll select this option, which is the correct one, right? So this is the second. Again, once you complete this, then you will get your score, whether it is right or wrong, whether it is correct or incorrect, it will give you the final answer, and then the next problem will come in front of you. Okay, so here is, it is the next problem. Again, you have to watch whether it is a rearrangement of order or not. So whether the plus is the third, so square is the first, so 2, 4, 1. 2, 4, 1, this is the correct answer, right? So here the pop-up will come regarding to tell you whether your answer is correct, your answer is incorrect, and what about that, that will happen over here, right? So here the third one is here the 3, then 4, right, then 2, and then 1. So this is correct answer has been correct, right? So this is again next question. The more you'll solve, the more number of questions, the more practice you'll be able to make. Now we are also developing few of the other games as well along with this. Games are being played and how it is helping really, really to get that real time feel, I could say, or real time assessment of the particular games, right? Here the third is first, order is 3, then 1, then 4, and then 2. Okay, so this is correct answer. So here it is 3, then 2, then 4, and then 1. Right, here it is correct. So accordingly you will be able to start, and whatever the scores that you are making along with the games that you are playing, that is being represented over here. Let's go to the next game, right? The next game is of identifying, guess the missing symbol, right? So here what they have given is, according to the even level of difficulty, the questions have been segregated, okay? The questions have been segregated, and according to that, you will be able to play them. According to that, you will be able to understand them. So here you need to understand out of the question mark, in the place of question mark, what kind of shape that will come out there. Okay, guess the missing symbol at the question mark. So accordingly, you have to identify, you have to answer. Okay, and unless and until you give the correct answer, it is not going to give you the next question. So that is really going to help you, help you understand what kind of logic you had applied, and again going to help you what kind of logic was correct, what kind of logic was incorrect, and accordingly it is going to help you to solve the further more questions, right? So when your answer is correct, the next question will be coming in front of you, right? Look at this. How does this work? Right, so what will come in front of the question mark, in the place of question mark, you have to identify the correct logic which has been there while placing rest other symbols there, and accordingly you have to give the answers. Okay, so students, I hope you all are getting it, you all are understanding it, and I have given the link for the registration of this course, of Capgemini course, which is helping you to prepare for the upcoming Capgemini drive, and in which you will get the access of this game based aptitude portal. Okay, so if you are really interested to play these games, if you are really interested to prepare for your Capgemini Excellence course, then register to that link, which has been registration link which has been given in the description of this video, so that our team will be getting in touch with you and they will be completing your enrollment for the course. So if you are really finding this helpful, if you are really finding this important, then just find that link in the description of the video and you'll be really able to practice for that. All those students who have joined there in the another meeting, they'll be getting the link for the joining on the YouTube channel, YouTube video, and accordingly they'll be able to do that. Okay, so let's go for the next game. Is symmetric image. Given images, are they symmetric or not, that you have to identify. So you have to give the two options you have been given, whether is it symmetric or not. So you have to identify it accordingly and you have to give the answer, and according to your correct or your wrong answer, it will give you the results as well in the pop-up, and you have to decide which answer that you are giving, whether it is correct or not, according to that, right? You have to just check. There are number of squares that have been given, and according to that you will be able to find out whether the given particular arrangement, whether given particular this thing, whether it is in the symmetry or not, right? So student, this is a very essential and very very important thing from the perspective of the Capgemini test, because most of the students find it challenging. Okay, this game based assessment, many of the students find it challenging, because drastically Capgemini has changed their entire recruitment pattern to the next level, and they have introduced this gamified assessment, and that has drastically made the huge difference in the entire recruitment process of Capgemini that was happening since last many years, right? So this is how you can prepare for the game based assessment, this is how you can prepare for them, and you can get the opportunity to get placed into a Capgemini recruitment test. Okay, so this is the last game where we'll be giving you the remember the order in which the dots appear on the grid and answer the question. So you have to remember on which this is going to be there in the on the grid, and accordingly you have to answer the questions. Okay, so just observe it carefully, try to remember the numbers, try to remember the summations that is going to be formed by having those numbers there in front of you, and accordingly immediately the question will pop up and you have to answer the question. Now what has appeared is, click on the circle which appeared at the last. Now I really haven't observed it carefully. Look at these students, it is really, really going to help you to find out the real-time answers of the questions that are coming in front of you. It will take around some times to give you the some clues, give you some ideas to come in front of you when the, all the numbers are coming, and accordingly you have to answer them, right? So, you know, what I am trying to tell you is the game-based aptitude is not only about. See, now the question is click on the circle which appeared the second last. So here now you will be able to understand how your observation skills, how your presence of mind, how you tackle all of these questions are going to really matter a lot, and that are going to play a vital role, important role when it is coming to the game based aptitude. Okay, so this is how we have developed our entire platform. Okay, now these are the four sample games which I have shown you in this live video, so that you will be able to really understand how we are going to help you to cope up and prepare with the game based aptitude for the Capgemini test. Now in the couple of more live sessions that we are conducting in most of the drives that will be there in front of you, and more in front of all the upcoming drives that will be coming in front of you in upcoming days. Now we will be making you all prepare for all the upcoming drives as well through our various courses. Now all those students who are really, really helping this video fruitful, insightful, and they want to prepare for the game based aptitude from our courses, just I have put the registration link in the description of this video. So go to that registration link, it is on the YouTube as well, and many of the students live on the this Zoom meeting as well. If you have any questions, any queries, students, just let me know so that I'll be able to answer them. Hope students, you have understood everything that I have explained over here. Okay, so in the last, I'll again reiterate that subscribe to our YouTube channel, and again tomorrow in our tomorrow's live session, we are going to conduct the English communication test. We are going to cover what and all the important topics that will be asked from the English communication test in the Capgemini recruitment test, the Capgemini pattern, and how you should prepare for the verbal ability English communication test that is being conducted in the Capgemini recruitment, and how you have to prepare for that, how you have to grab the opportunity into a Capgemini test, right? So that is going to help you to prepare for Capgemini recruitment, right? So stay tuned with us, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on all our social handles, and keep updated with us, so that we will help you out for the different placement opportunity that is coming in front of you. Okay, so thank you students, thanks a lot, thank you so much.